Hallo zusammen!
As part of my ongoing journey through the new Rammstein lyrics, we've arrived at song number 5 on the new album today. The song is called Sex, which itself isn't too out of the ordinary for Rammstein standards, I'd say. I don't think. But then again, let's find out what this song is about, if it's about what we all think it's about, or maybe not. Let's talk about Sex by Rammstein today. The song's overall structure isn't too complicated or too surprising in a way, but that doesn't have to mean something bad. It's just the way it is, the nature of the song, which is really groovy, really, well, swing-ish, I'd say, in a Rammstein way, which I really like when rock or metal music sounds like that, when it really has a groove to it, something you can, well, not really dance, but maybe move along to, and this is one of those songs. The riffing is awesome in this one. However, I'd say on the lyrical side of things, compared to most other Rammstein tunes, this one is a bit less ambiguous and more direct. What does that mean? Well, let's try to find that out. Let's take a look at the first verse of the swing or groove rock track. Ich seh dich an und mir wird schlecht. Überall das dralle Fleisch. Ich schau dir tief in das Geschlecht und die Knie werden weich. Tausend Nadeln, das Verlangen, will Geruch mit Händen fangen. I look at you and it makes me sick. Full bodied or chubby flesh everywhere. I look deeply into your sex or gender or genitals and the knees go or turn weak. A thousand needles, the desire. Want to catch smell with hands. From a German's perspective, there's especially one interesting term which can be found in the second line. Dralle, an inflected adjective directly related to Fleisch, flesh. And by the way, whereas in English you'd distinguish rather strictly between flesh and meat, we'd use the neuter noun das Fleisch for both human flesh and animal meat. It's a general term, so to speak. The infinite form of this adjective is Drall, and even though it's not an extremely outdated German term, I don't think, you definitely won't hear this one in daily colloquial German overly often, if at all. It means, well, something like well-rounded or well-proportioned, something along these lines. Putting linguistic explanations aside for a moment, the very first line is just hilarious. It's not just the meaning itself, but also the way singer Till Lindemann conveys and verbalizes these terms with his dark and funny intonation. Love that. The third line is equally interesting, but from a more language-related standpoint this time around. In German, das Geschlecht, singular, die Geschlechter, plural, can be a very ambiguous term. It either means a person's biological sex, meaning the gender, it might also mean a linguistic gender in a rather colloquial way, and in a slightly shortened way it can also refer to das Geschlechtsteil, singular, die Geschlechtsteile, plural, the genital. Especially both these biological backgrounds I just mentioned really go hand in hand in this case. Ich schau dir tief in das Geschlecht. So, let's think about it. Does the lyrical eye simply take a direct look at the other person's genitals? Or do they reflect on that person's gender, related thoughts, or even stereotypes? Who knows? In a more indirect way, this sentence could also imply that they do some research on a person's family tree or heritage, that person's ancestry, so to speak. Translated literally, the line und die Knie werden weich would translate to and the knees become or turn soft, which I guess could still be understood in the intended way. The noun das Knie, singular, die Knie, plural, is a very special one, and you might already be able to tell why. In written form, they look exactly the same. In fact, it's the pronunciation that differs and can tell us more about a singular or plural form, apart from a grammatical context, of course. Knie is singular, and Knie is plural. Let's continue with the pre-chorus. Weiß, das Hirn kriecht in die Venen, und es singen die Sirenen. Eine Faust in meinem Bauch, komm her, du willst es doch auch. No, or white, the brain or mind crawls into the veins, and the sirens sing. A fist in my stomach, come here, you want it too. In German, the term weiß can either refer to the color white or to a conjugated form of the verb wissen, to know. For instance, in the first person singular, Präsens, simple present, indicative mode active. Ich weiß, I know. Gotta be honest with you, I'm not too sure why this line opens with this term and why it introduces the whole phrase, but maybe you have a clue. It could imply something like I know or you have to know, du weißt Bescheid, something like that, but maybe it means something else. Who knows? Maybe you do. Similar to English, das Hirn, a synonym or alternate form of das Gehirn, singular, die Gehirne, plural, or die Hirne, plural, can either refer to the brain or, in a more abstract way, to the mind and spirit of someone, to the thoughts, so to speak. I mean, during sex, which undoubtedly is the core theme of the song, or at least, well, the big one, because I think there is another level about relationships and how both things work with each other, in a way. You basically shut off your brain, relax, and are emotional instead of reflecting and thinking too much. So I guess this might be a plausible meaning here. Since some like it a bit more, well, physically engaging, the fist in the stomach is a rather direct imagery, I'd say. Some might even go a bit too far in terms of exhaustion, so the sirens might start ringing here, well, as a warning, for instance. And as it's the case in English, the German noun die Sirene, singular, die Sirenen, plural, can mean both a siren, meaning a mermaid singing on a rock or cliff, or simply a siren. A horn or emergency siren. The metaphor of a singing mermaid is often rather negatively connotated because this behavior is said to have lured sailors away from their course into disasters or even death. So that is a rather delicate thought here. A little interesting ambiguity, at least I think that could be the case here. The phrase du willst es doch auch, you want it too, or a similar form ich weiß, du willst es doch auch, I know you want it too, is a commonly known phrase in a rather erotic or sexual context, which can be found in some novels, lyrics, or prose. The following first chorus is a slightly shorter version of the second one, but up until that point they are exactly identical, so I'm gonna talk about the full version right away. Sex! Komm zu mir! Meins ist deins und das in dir. Sex! Komm mit mir, denn besser widerlich als wieder nicht. Wir leben nur einmal. Wir lieben das Leben. Wir lieben die Liebe. Sex. Come to me. Mine is yours and that in you. Sex. Come with me. Since it's better nasty than not again at all. We only live once. We love the life. We love the love. So counting like a typical German with my fingers, 1 and 3, those lines might be a bit confusing to foreigners, I could see fit, I could imagine, because they sound very, very similar, only one term is different. And we're talking about die Präposition singular, die Präpositionen plural, the preposition here. In the first case, it's komm zu mir, come to me, whereas in the second case, it's komm mit mir, come with me. The first one could be interpreted more one-sided, quite demanding even, while the second one is a bit more bilateral and could be seen as more positive, because it might be referring to a more romantic kind of relationship. So I'm gonna throw in a personal opinion now. This chorus right here features both a few of my favorites and a few of my least favorite lines or lyrics on the entire album. For instance, I really love the line denn besser widerlich als wieder nicht. It sounds great because of the slightly phonetic similarity between widerlich, nasty, and wieder nicht, not again at all, in spoken German at least, and the bottom line is just hilarious. It's better to have really, really disgusting and nasty sex than none at all. In combination, I think it's a cleverly written lyrical phrase. On a side note here, Till could have made it sound even more similar by dropping the consonant T at the end of nicht, not, no one, not a or none, which commonly happens in daily colloquial spoken German anyway. You wouldn't spell it like that, of course, because that's not the ordinary, the typical form of this term, but in spoken colloquial German it's totally common to drop those consonants every here and there. On the other hand, you have lines like wir leben nur einmal, And even though it's sort of the plural German equivalent to the slang term YOLO, you only live once in English, it really makes me think of calendar phrases and over general sentences you might read on many postcards, etc. Nothing really outstanding or really thought-provoking, pretty much an empty phrase without a context. Arguably here you have some sort of context, you pretty much underline the importance or the joy of having sex in a way, but still, I don't know. In this context, in these lyrics here, I'm not a big fan of those kinds of phrases for the most part. So the second verse is shorter than the first one. It goes, Ich seh dich an und mir wird schlecht, heute fallen auf die Haut. Ich schau dir tiefer ins Geschlecht, Leib und Brüste gut gebaut. I look at you and it makes me sick, skins fall onto the skin. I look deeper into your genitals, sex or gender, body and breasts well built or well developed. I haven't mentioned that the first time, but the phrasing mir wird schlecht is different to the English it makes me sick from a syntactical point of view, the structure pretty much. A literal translation of the German phrase is me becomes or me gets sick. It's similar to expressions like mir ist kalt or mir ist warm, me is cold or me is hot, me is warm pretty much in that sense, which you would express differently in English. The second line, heute fallen auf die Haut, skins fall onto the skin, could imply that the lyrical I has sex with more than just one person at a time, since it's multiple skins that fall onto that one skin. Also, it might imply that the lyrical I might be the one that rather, well, how should I say it, the part that rather embraces the sex without being the dominant part, the active part, so to speak, being passive. But maybe that's going too far, I don't know. Now, the lyrical eye looks even deeper into or at the other person's sex or genitals, so I think there's definitely some kind of interest in the other person, which might go beyond sort of a one-night standish type of sex. I don't know. The second pre-chorus is slightly different to the first one. It goes, Es ist ein Beben, ist ein Schwingen, und die Sirenen singen, ein Verlangen unterm Bauch. Komm her, denn du willst es doch auch. As you can see, it's once again subtle things that change here and there, and I think that really is a driving force of the song. Something is swinging and the desire is below the belly and, you know. When we finally take a look at the post-chorus or bridge section, the term ja is the German equivalent interjection to yes in English. It's as easy as that. So, overall, an interesting, really groovy track that contains quite a few playful and creative expressions while still being a bit more direct and not so ambiguous in comparison to many other Rammstein tunes. But once again, that doesn't mean anything in terms of evaluation or, well, me liking the song more or less. That's just a statement. So I wonder, what do you think about the song? I think overall on the album, it's a good, a solid tune, but I wouldn't call it one of my favorites necessarily, because I think there are stronger songs, both in terms of musical arrangement, the composition, the hook lines, and also on the lyrical side of things, because I usually prefer lyrics that are more in-depth, more diverse in a way, and not perverse, haha. No, joking aside, which wasn't that funny. Anyway, it's a typical Rammstein song, but it's not too special in a way. But what do you guys think? I'd like to know, because I'm curious. It's music, and I love music, and it's Rammstein, I love Rammstein, and when both things combine, the universe explodes. Unfortunately, I didn't manage to get any Rammstein tickets for the upcoming 2020 tour. I tried to get some tickets for Berlin, for instance, but it's just not possible. Anyway, thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming Rammstein lyric interpretation analysis videos like this one and even more stuff, other videos on this channel as well. Thanks for watching once again. I'm your Vlog Dave. Tschüss und bis zum nächsten Mal.